myself.
I think we got Stan. Can you hear me? Okay, good, good, good. So I think we got everybody here. I'll pop up my thing.
It's a dark and stormy night as the bright moon glows and in the distance a wolf howls. You dive into a fantastical journey into the dark castle of imagination below. The door to the castle swings open wide, and you gaze briefly as magic and melee dance the macabre in a masterful dance of malicious malign. You turn and head down the dark steps of the castle, where fearful flying falcons face fuming, fanged phantasms of evil. And the dark red door with a silver snake handle opens to a library full of specters and spacious slithering serpents as Tasha swirls her magically lit flame to her cauldron below, serving in the seething and surreal. She swirls her staff in the homebrewed realm of wonder and fantasy, where the ruin or riches that befall you rely on polyhedral deities. A heart-shaped skull comprised of the fumes of the homebrew rise to meet your gaze as you plunge below into her realm full of demons and angels, elves and magic, dungeons and dragons.
And onions.
Last time on Dungeons and Dragons, we noticed that the arms match the statues and start connecting the ones that match. As limbs become connected, the chain slowly slackens. When all the limbs are connected to a statue, its chain silently withdraws into the middle statue. Some of the limbs turn into mimics, attacking us during our task. Although during all this, Elceris took some time to jerk it. Ivana touches a mirror and has an LSD vision of Elceris in a BDSM scene. Very accurate. Some of the mimics we're fighting morph together into a Guillermo del Toro nightmare anime tentacle creature. Spells and arrows rain down on the mimics, and we banish them all. 330 XP is given to everyone. When all the limbs are attached, the chains are all sucked into the statue, and a purple glow emits from the creature statue, from the center statue, which slides upwards, revealing a staircase. And now, the continuing adventures of Homebrew, the Silver Saga.
Okay, so, to give everybody a glimpse of where you're at, I've already shared the owlbear link, but we're going to go ahead and turn on the sound as we share the screen for this. Hang on 1 second while I get all of you into view. All right, great. Yeah, so you are right now in the third level of this temple that you have entered into. It is a slightly musty open chamber. 50 feet in front of you is a wall that presumably blocks everything from this side to the other side of that wall. The room itself is lit. On the side of the walls are dragon statues with flames breathing from their eyes and mouths that light up enough of the room for you all to see. There are a couple of bones littered across this particular room. Other than that, that's it. And now the continuing adventures. I'll let you guys decide what you want to do.
I'm looking for traps.
Okay,
Can Stan do his magic thingy?
So Jekogani was first. So Jekogani, how do you want to search for these traps?
With my eyes.
Nicely done. Give me an investigation check. Okay. Alexa, shuffle my playlist D&D Bois.
15.
Shuffling your playlist.
From what you can tell, this just appears to be an empty room, littered with dark and musty bones.
Cool. Hey guys, I don't see any traps. I think we're good.
cool.
So, anybody else?
I'd like to take a look over in that pile of bones over there on the left. Maybe just kind of like poke it a little bit with my longbow and just kind of see what's going on there.
To the left here, right? All right. So you want to go over here and kind of like, check out this pile of bones here, right?
What's going on in there? Just like,
all right. Well, it doesn't seem like it's too far away. Yeah, it's only about like 25 feet from where you were. So why don't you give me an investigation check?
We're going to go ahead and do that right now. Well, hey, we're going to go ahead and make that a nat 20.
Really? Holy shit.
Well, 22, but...
Okay, well, holy fuck.
Outstanding.
So you find 200 gold.
Shit, yeah.
Yeah.
There's gold in these things, you see
something glittering in that pile of bones. You dust easily away the things atop of it, and you find 200 gold pieces just kind of scattered amidst these bones, which you quickly pick up.
That a boy.
This shit's mad. All right. Well.
So,
I'm pretty sure that means none of the rest of the bones are going to have gold. It's all going to be mimics.
Yeah, right.
So, next in line.
Do you want to go in order? Because, I'm cool with that.
I don't give a shit, actually, at this point.
Well, okay. So, real quick, it takes me 10 minutes to do the ritual. So, while everyone's doing stuff, can I just be setting up my ritual for detect magic?
Sure. You get your lavender candles placed on each four corners of yourself. Well. Yeah. You have your lute music on your fantasy MP3, which is actually just a rune stone that you can hear in your mind. It's really wild. I made that canon, didn't I?
It
looks like a Microsoft Zune.
Is it a Microsoft rune?
That's good.
Standing.
So I guess you
can tell it is because it's entirely unsupported anymore.
So you are prepping. Where you're at, and then prepping, or do you want to go into a corner, or what are you trying to do?
Since
you're playing as Elceris's character, what is Elceris doing?
Oh yeah, Elceris is going to go to the opposite direction of Jericho and investigate over in this area.
Elceris, why don't you give me an investigation check?
Gladly. Hold on, let me pull up a sheet.
Sure, of course.
What is this sheet?
What is this sheet?
Fudge.
Are you trying to be racist?
This your cousin? Let's go ahead and do that first. All right. Okay.
Because she is our cousin.
Yeah, that's
hilarious.
So fun. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I rolled a 12. I just want to see what my modifiers are. So investigation. I'm sorry. Investigation. Son of a bitch. There you go. Plus 5. Yeah, buddy. That would be a 17.
Holy shit. You find 100 gold.
Fuck yes.
Damn. Oh,
that's for L, by the way.
Sure. Damn. Okay. Pinnaman, what are you doing?
Well, I definitely want to check to see if I can get some gold. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Are you also checking?
Okay, good. So now I know that both of you are checking. Where are you checking?
I'll drag my guy over here.
Okay, good, good, good. Thank you. At this point, if you guys are already, if you have the owlbear link, please feel free to move yourself when it's your turn. And don't be an asshole. But, you know, none of these people are in this group, so we're good. Oh, God. Should I turn off my music so that way you can play yours?
No, it doesn't matter. I'm just playing some notes just, like I'm doing something.
Sure.
If I want to play a song, I'll let you know.
Yeah. All right. Cool. All right, so you are over here on the, let's say, the third pile of the five piles of bones that you guys see. Oh, no, Pinnaman, you have activated in your, from going across there, you have a poison dart come at you from the left wall. Why don't you go ahead and roll a dexterity check? Or roll a dexterity saving throw, rather.
Dexterity saving throw.
Ten.
Ooh, the poison dart does hit you, in fact, and, that wasn't the, you know what I'm trying to say. It hits you, you take 4 damage, and you are now poisoned.
Cunning dodge, I'll take 2 damage.
But oh, shit! Yeah, hell yeah! You know, now we've got ourselves a game. All right, there we go.
Outstanding.
It's always good when you when people know what's going on. All right, so so you take 2 damage. You are poisoned. Go ahead. You are muted. So if you are trying to tell me something,
do I record the poison on the thing?
Like, where do we record on the character sheet that he's poisoned?
Oh man.
On the top right, it says conditions, add active conditions.
Thank you. Okay, great. Because you are hit with this poison dart from the left side of the wall, your vision is a little blurry, so you're having trouble investigating. So now we will move
come over here. There's darts.
Silver is going to start looking along the line, along the sides of the wall. Just trying to
look in. I know
trying to do an investigation.
Remember, how much gold did Ray get again? I know I'm supposed to remember.
100.
Fuck. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. So Silver does an investigation check to sense anything on the side of the walls.
And when I did one, I rolled an 11.
Nice. Okay. Hang on for me 1 second. Oh, you already moved your character. Yes. All right. You appear to see nothing but bones. And oh no, as you scooped away some a bit of skull, one of the many statues on the side of the wall that lights this particular room shoots a fireball directly in your direction. Roll a dexterity saving throw.
I had some shit for this. I guess not.
No.
Nat 20 plus 1.
Yeah!
Outstanding.
You fucking dodged that shit. You ever seen Shaolin soccer? It's kind of like that. you managed to send the ball of fire back in the direction where it came from using your swift ass kicks. And,
that movie was amazing.
And it destroys the one of the statues on the side, the one that shot the fireball at you. The room is a little bit dimmer because that light source has now gone out. But hey, you know, one less trap to worry about. Awesome. Silver, meanwhile, has discovered that a little late to the game, but she has discovered, I believe that some of these light sources will try to fire at you if you step in a certain direction. I don't think that you guys should go anywhere near them.
I mutter, bitch.
Thank you, Paladin, for your help in this situation. Now that I'm nearly blinded, and now you're telling us the third draft.
She tries to she kind of
servant.
Yeah, she kind of looks over on her side of things and kind of like kicks the gravel beneath her. She tries to tap on her centerpiece, but nothing happens. She seems concerned, but she also has that look about it that says she doesn't want to raise any alarm.
She's too cool.
Yeah. Now we move on to Jekogani. Jekogani, what are you doing?
I would like to carefully move my way over to Miniman and use Lesser Restoration to cure his poison.
Ooh. All right. Let's, I want you to still use a dexterity check for me. Let's see. Oh no, there's a flying dart comes down to you from the ceiling. Roll a dexterity saving throw.
From the ceiling?
From the ceiling, there is a that you hear in the air before a dart comes square your way, seemingly dropping from the sky. Oh, and it hits you! You are hit for 4 damage, and you take poison damage. Or you are now poisoned. 2 peas in a pod, you guys. It's a lot of fun.
Well,
so,
lesser restoration on myself.
I will do the... Well, do it. All right, you know what? You already got hit with the dart. We'll come back to you. You're... Ivana, what are you doing?
I'm just gonna move over here and look around, I guess.
Okay, roll an investigation check, please.
Speaking of restoration, I have 26 of 42 hit points. Just putting that out there.
Okay.
Oh my god. 10?
Oh no! to the right wall, one of the statues hurls a fireball at you. Roll a dexterity saving throw. Oh shit! you managed to, you've never seen it done before. But you hear the fireball coming, you jump at the right moment, and then you are on top of the ball. You counterclockwise, it's spin, and you put out the flame on this fireball and just turn it into a lump, a ball of ash that crumbles beneath your feet.
Nice.
Yeah, the light in the back of that particular dragon's eyes and mouth go out, and that light source is no longer available. But it seems like you have disarmed a trap, so way to go. Let's see. Now, let's go back to Jekogani, or not Jekogani. Let's go back to Jericho. Jericho, what are you doing?
First thing, I like lean over to Ivana, and I put a hand on her shoulder. And I'm like, that's a spicy meatball. to the fireball that came at her, just because you know, that was pretty dangerous with the poison darts and everything. I'd like to find out if there's like any other passages or anything else like that in the room, I guess, that's readily visible.
From where you're at?
Or I mean, like, is this it? Is this all that we got here?
Roll an investigation check.
Is that a 6? It looks like it.
This appears to be all that that there is in this room. Oh no, it's a big spooky room.
Okay.
Yeah. Great. I'm gonna go in the order that I see you guys. So, Pinnaman, what are you doing?
Just trying to feel my way around and see if I can grab something with my blindness.
Still okay. you get disadvantage on this, but roll an investigation check. The poison seeps through your body and you take another 2 damage.
Plus, investigation. 5.
Okay. It's a big, empty, spooky room. That damage is still on. Jekogani, let's go to you. You're right next to Pinnaman.
I'm going to cast Lesser Restoration on myself to cure my poison.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Okay, roll a Wisdom. Or no, is it something else for you?
Oh, that's Wisdom.
Yeah. All right, great. Yeah, let's roll a Wisdom.
It takes a lot of wisdom to know how to touch yourself just right.
And how?
16.
Nice.
Outstanding.
The your poison is lifted. It just seems to be bad gas. That's awesome. So now we move on to, again, just the way that I see you guys. Leolin, what are we doing?
Hold on, I gotta see how far I am. Where's that measure tool?
It's
you gotta check over here.
I'm gonna try to.
Thanks. You mean it's somewhere in this direction?
I don't think this is worth it. I'm just gonna keep walking around. I'm gonna go over here. Whoops.
Okay.
Go up here.
Where? If you use the hand symbol, you could drag your character.
I'm over here.
Oh, there you are. Okay.
Going from here to there.
Sure. All right.
I'm gonna look around in this.
All right. Give me another investigation check.
18 and it bumped over. Now it's a 6.
Oh no, a big spooky empty room. Belarus, it's your turn. Alexa, right, pause.
At this point I have finished my ritual, so I have a 30-foot bubble of detect magic.
Nice.
I finished tuning my G string.
That's a 30-foot a 30-foot radius surrounds you. Okay.
Yeah. I'm going to move to here, 25 feet. As I move in that direction, I would also like to do an investigation check.
Okay. And this bubble that surrounds you, what does it do exactly?
One moment, please.
Yeah, sure. Really?
All right, choose... Wait, dispel... No, not dispel. Damn it, hold on.
Yeah, sure.
You think I'd be better at this?
Hey, we're all terrible at this, so don't worry about it.
Detect magic. There we go. All right, for the duration... up to 10 minutes, concentration, do-to-do. For the duration, you sense the presence of magic within 30 feet of you. If you sense magic in this way, you can use your action to see a faint aura. Oh, I guess that's my action. To see a faint aura around any visible creature or object in the area that bears magic.
Okay.
You learn its school of magic, if any. The spell can penetrate most barriers, but it is blocked by 1 foot of stone, 1 inch of common metal, a thin sheet of lead, or 3 feet of wood or dirt.
Okay.
So
blocked. 3 feet of wood.
Hey-o.
I heard that too. That's funny. He also said
Silvera says, I too got that one.
Oh, we have something in common. We do.
I got, she continues to check the walls as if, yeah.
Just face on the wall.
The so you, the only magic you detect is a strong demonic magic coming shit. From Elceris.
Oh shit.
Oh, that's normal.
He usually gets like this. What was that? Not like this.
When he was jerking it, I saw his pee-pee and it looked like a dog's lipstick. Anyway,
okay, yeah, this
I
is
wouldn't mess with him too much, man.
This is also concerning because then what happened to my demonic magic? Did it go away?
Yeah, me.
Do you have demonic magic?
Yeah, I'm like a.
You're demonic. Like a half dragon. Aren't you? You've got draconic blood, but you don't have demonic blood.
Oh, yeah, it's draconic. Never mind.
Yeah. Sorry.
Technically, if anyone has demonic blood, it's me.
Right.
Yeah, it would be the tiefling, huh?
It would be the tiefling. Who knows?
Tiefling or tiefling? I never did.
You got me. I'm sure somebody who is smarter than us knows, or nerdier than us, rather.
It's tiefling. In German, it's I before E is like niece. And then E before I is like Einstein, and that's basically the rule of thumb I always go with.
E, I.
Except after C?
So no, tiefling? After C.
The easier way is just if it's EI or IE, it's just whatever the second letter is. That.
What if it's EI, EI, and then an L following that? Is that a...
Then it's a farmer.
Nice.
That joke's for everybody. We all take four psychic damage. Jesus Christ.
Shit.
Jericho, what are you doing? No.
Elceris, perhaps?
Elceris, yes. What is Elceris doing?
Elceris is.
Alexa, resume.
Oh, shit. I should probably move to the other side. So basically, what you're telling me is these different rubbles, these bone rubbles, is what we're like trying to investigate.
Currently you are just trying to investigate the room itself.
Okay. Alright,
you already know what upstairs leads to.
That's those stairs right there.
Yeah, there have been a couple of, so far, mechanical traps, that you have found, some that you've disabled.
Okay, I am going to move into this direction here and investigate this corner. If we haven't investigated it yet.
I
looked over here.
Pinnaman tried to, but he was hit with a poison dart. Jekyll Ghani came to his aid. And I think that's as far as we've got for this corner. So while you're over here, why don't you give me
You know what? Does anybody need healing? I forgot that I have healing touch.
I'm at 19 out of 28.
19 out of 28, and then so Leolin and Jekyll Ghani.
Really?
And I'm 26 out of 42.
26, and then Jekyll Ghani said 18. And Jekyll Ghani happened.
I'm at 19.
I'm 7 out of 12.
God,
how are you 12?
12 hit points.
I don't know. I have 12 hit points. Okay, rude, but okay.
Because everybody else is something for Silver, but Silver's kind of badass, so what are you going to do?
Wait, I'm at 12. Okay, it says 29 out of 34 now.
That's good. Does that work? That's okay, acceptable. Cool. That's acceptable.
What did I get healed for?
What's up? Oh, you got healed for half of whatever Elceris heals for. I think Elceris
gave me half of that. Thank you.
Yeah, okay, so you got it, but you only heal for half of what it says you heal for.
Is that because it was so low?
Exactly.
You are a benevolent DM. Okay. Then you get 6 HP.
6. Oh.
Thank you.
Yeah. Wait, just him or both of us?
You are welcome. Unfortunately, just
the people that are near,
far away from me right now. Elceris.
I feel like
fucking busted through French doors. It's like a fucking cologne.
Holy shit, that's canon now.
New fragrance from.
Yeah, whenever El Saris leaves a room, it's El Saris.
Carmen San Diego.
Yeah. That's beautiful. That's good. That's a fun little character trait.
I like it.
Way to go, Stan. Let's see. I'll let you guys free for all. Whoever has or wants to do an action should. Before you guys go into saying stuff, Silver still checks the walls aligning. Oh, God damn. Silver checks the walls. Does a moment. I think there's still some traps over here, or at least in the room. I'm guessing anyway. I've never really been without my win. She looks sad, and she continues to, search the walls. Okay, thank you. Yeah, that's where she's at, exploring the walls. All right, now who, anybody else wants to, go? It's a free-for-all, so I mean, like, tell me what you want to do.
Lesser Restoration on Pinnaman.
Nice. Roll of Charisma. Nice. Roll that Charisma. Jericho, what are you doing?
I'm thinking, don't we got a dragon to kill? What are we doing in this sarcophagus? I wanna get back to dragon killing.
Bella Rose.
Outstanding.
You heal.
Jericho, you should check on Silvera's arm to see if she is quite all right.
I look at Bailey and I just wink real slow, like, and I'm like, I hear you, buddy. And then I turn over and I position myself next to this busty Silvera and I say, hey, what the fuck are you looking at these walls for?
Cannon? she turns to you and says, what? Oh, sorry. This makes no sense. I mean, we're here to kill the dragon and all we're seeing is just a room. This can't be right. There's got to be like some sort of trap door, like what happened upstairs. Help me search, won't you?
Let's do this thing, babe. And then right. I take a longbow and just poke things. I don't know.
Roll an investigation check. As you're poking stuff, oh no, you don't even need to roll a dexterity check. Shit. You would have nailed it, but unfortunately, because of your poking around, pun intended, debris falls from the ceiling on top of you. Roll a dexterity saving throw.
Jesus Christ! As I attempt.
Yeah.
Well, fuck, man.
You take 4 damage.
God damn. That shit hurt like a son of a bitch.
Sorry, you don't take 4 damage. Give me a moment.
Okay. Now I'm cool with that. If that's your ruling, I mean, like, I ain't gonna say no to that.
Right.
If you're saying it.
If it's something that's
Yeah, you take 4 damage.
Huh. Yeah, fuck. All right.
It's like The polyhedral deities were with you on that one, I guess. I don't know. I wanted to give you more.
As I'm getting crushed by the roof, I say, damn you, love!
Okay, super quick. El Saris is going to move.
Well, El Saris has kind of had his turn doing his thing. So why don't we figure out what Leolin is doing?
I'm sorry.
I am going to look for traps.
Okay. Why, still in the area that you're at?
I'm going to look for them wherever it seems like maybe they might be.
Okay.
So probably like this area.
Okay. You're doing an investigation check still. So you already... somewhere in that direction there. Yeah. Oh God. Oh God.
My connection's so bad. That is making my computer freak out. Like,
yeah, give me an investigation check, you silly. The beautiful light dances.
17.
Nice. You managed to... tap on a piece of the floor. It's not an actual piece of the floor. It's actually just a debris over a couple of rocks that lead down into a small pit. So you have disarmed this particular trap. So hang on for me 1 second while I...
Ooh, nice job. You disarmed it. Really?
Six more boings. We got this fucker.
Okay. Yeah. So that is what Leolin does. Thank you, Leolin, for disarming a trap. Now we want to figure out what Pinnaman is doing.
Well, I'm very thankful to have my eyesight back. So sure. I do want to take a better look at this floor as well, like Leolin. So I kind of want to investigate the cracks in these tiles.
Okay. Roll an investigation check, please.
Investigation. 12.
Seem like a bunch of cracks in the floors to you.
Oh.
Yeah. Jekogani, what are you doing?
I am going to... we're gonna just kind of look around from where I am to see if anything looks out of the ordinary.
Another investigation check, please.
16.
You...
Outstanding.
You feel from the side, from the back side of the room where the wall is placed, you feel a draft.
It's drafty over here.
What? Silver, what? Where?
Over here, where I am, where I said over here.
All right, I'll come to you.
Don't leave me, bitch. I'm covered in roof.
Oh, yeah, shit. Let's see if she's able to safely rescue you from this debris. Hang on for me 1 second. She tries to lift some of the debris off of you. She hits your head instead. You don't take any more damage, but, yeah. I'm sorry, I didn't know it was just gonna crumble like that. I didn't... I'm sorry,
Nuggets and Anderson.
See, he seems fine, is what she says. Ivana, what are you doing?
Okay. So... I'm wondering, where's the draft coming from? Can you show me?
Sure. Draft is coming from... Thank you. I didn't want to fuck up her computer even more. Yeah, where the yellow...
I want to go.
Yeah, it's kind of over there. Yeah, all right. So it's over there. Yep. All right. Basically, where those things are dancing. What are the things from Link?
Okay, well, I'll go right there because I can only go 30 feet.
Berries?
Was it? They didn't have like a special name for that, for those particular ones? Okay, yeah. Where the two yellow and green fairies have been flittering around. Shit, that's canon now. Oh God, now there's more of them.
Going by a will of the wisdom.
Awesome.
Everybody roll a wisdom saving throw.
Oh no.
What did we do to you?
Well, no, because now there's all sorts of magic being flooding this room. Oh, okay.
And then Elceris got an 18.
Damn. Okay, so everybody but Jericho is able to steve themselves from this from this barrage of magic that just went on over here. And Jericho, you take 2 damage.
Sorry, dude. Like, I thought we were
bullshit. I just came out from the woods and I'm covered in proof right now. I am expanded.
I'd like to argue the point that there never were any magic.
There were never any magic fairies in there. Yeah, I know. That was on me. That was me being an asshole. DM.
Cartoonish experience where the little birds were fluttering around his head and one of them shat on his eye. And that's where the damage came from.
I like that explanation way better. Can you be DM afterwards?
And then I developed that vision. This is awesome.
All right. Who else is going?
Okay. I'm going to move Elceris closer to Leolin for a heal. And it is exactly 30 feet away, so that's perfect.
Great.
So let's go ahead and do that. Leolin, it looks as though you need a heel.
I sure do.
Not like on your foot, but like
inside.
Silver stops trying to lift the debris off Jericho and says, that was good.
Thank you. I've been thinking of that one for quite some time. What do I do again? Let's see.
She turns back to you. Wasn't that funny? She's still trying to lift the debris off.
All right, we're going to do...
I'm hard as diamond.
What are you at? Okay. What are you at again?
Well, that's... I didn't know.
26.
26 out of your 40-something?
42.
Gosh, okay, I'll do another level 2. Why not? And first, should I roll to see if it goes off?
Yes.
Yes. But of course. 15.
Outstanding.
Yeah, you successfully heal.
Is that really Belly's accent? 15. I feel like you're stealing that from something.
It was not a Belly. That was more of a, you know, it doesn't matter.
Yep.
At this point.
I love you anyway.
Aw. Like? Hold on, let me do some math real quick. 12.
Fucking friendship test.
16. I got you for 16.
Nice.
Fuck yes.
Fuck yeah, dude. Way to go.
Outstanding.
I'm sorry, 15.
Tell him, bring me my money.
I don't have that on this one. It's D&D. I didn't know where it was going to fit.
Well.
Oh, yeah. That would make sense.
Either way, I'm full up. I'm filled with healing.
Awesome.
I am filled with Christ's love.
Bring my cup overflowing. This is not a weapon.
In your mind, you see a bunch of white people swaying their arms in unison.
If they start speaking in tongues, I'm getting the fuck out of here.
They're in unison. It's not a Christian church, so we're fine.
Keep the fucking beat, people. Jesus Christ, come on. No, that's...
Can I go ahead and have Belarus?
I want to know what Penniman is doing.
Well, I feel very, very full of shame for thinking that the floor had anything else to do with anything. So I walk over to the corner where Jekko Ogani felt the draft. And
sit down.
I'd like to investigate that more.
All right. You already know. Roll the. I love that movie.
I rolled a wonderful 5. Yeah.
You feel drafty. You have a vain moment where you kind of take like a supermodel thing where you're like, you know, you let the wind kind of flow through your hair a little bit. The rest of the party kind of looks at you and you get slightly embarrassed.
I mean, naturally, yeah. Guys, but I had to take a moment.
Jack Ogani, what are you doing?
I'm gonna tap this wall with my club.
The wall that's closest to you, or the back?
The wall that's closest to where the draft is coming from.
Okay.
So I poke it with my club.
Sure. So, Pin is over here. He's doing his thing. Jack Ogani is.
He always decides to solve things by poking them.
You already know what that check needs to be, so let's go ahead and get that investigate.
Also a 5.
Managed to break the tip of your cane.
But just the tip.
Just the tip.
Just damn it. Pretty good.
Outstanding.
Good joke, everyone.
Can I move that Belarus real quick?
Yes, Belarus. Sorry, what are we doing? My bad. I really should just start going in order and then.
That's fine.
You know, it's like a good DM.
It seems like I'm going twice because I got two characters, so I get it. I am going to move to this spot right here and investigate this area.
Okay. Roll an investigation check.
Yes. I investigate with my instrument too.
Sure. At the same time.
Yeah.
Just firing investigation shots off like randomly.
Oh, there we go.
Much like, oh no, that's Kung Fu Hustle.
They have the thing.
Is that good? An 18.
Outstanding.
Fantastic.
Notice a stone that doesn't appear to be positioned correctly. It's out of place with the rest of the stones in the room.
Of these things is not like the others.
Look around, or you look at the stone itself, then you look more around the room, and with the roll that you've just given me, you do see up at the top left-hand corner of the ceiling is what appears to be a rope attached to a very large cylindrical beam.
Oh, wow. Everybody, there's a rope.
Let's pull it.
Covered in roof.
Thanks, Billy. You hear from a ghost.
Ooh.
Sorry. Let's pull that rope.
How tall is the ceiling, though?
The ceiling is at least 15 feet high.
Fuck.
Alexa, yeah, but how
far down is the rope dangling?
The rope is not dangling.
It's just on the ceiling.
It's on the ceiling attached to something that you can't see. Hmm. And then
can we maybe like fire a fire arrow up there?
Yeah, who's firing the arrow? Sorry.
I'll do it.
I'll let your party decide how you're going to play the fucking game. I need to.
Leolin, what if you attached a rope to your arrow as you fire it to the other rope? Is that a good idea?
I don't know. I'm thinking if I start that rope on fire, then whatever it's holding is gonna come crashing down.
Oh no.
or do we want to try to like grab the rope, because I could try to jump up the wall and Spider-Man that shit.
I'm covered in roof, but I say
don't forget about that fucking brick in the wall.
What?
I'm covered in roof.
We don't need no education.
Oh God,
Bards, I hope you're recording this for the
Silver stops trying to take stones off of you.
Yep, I deserve it.
What if I tied a rope to my arrow and then fired it over the other rope?
Yes.
And then we could pull it with the rope around it.
Yes, that is a good idea.
All right.
I like that idea.
I'm gonna fire my bow and arrow up over the arrow and the ceiling so that we can pull on it.
Okay. Roll a strength check.
Not a dexterity.
Fuck. You're having to pull this arrow back pretty far.
It's a good try.
So, what ends up happening is the arrow flies, and the rope that was loosely attached to it comes undone. And it strays the trajectory of the arrow itself, and it cuts the rope that was holding that long cylindrical shape.
What kind of weak-ass rope is holding this thing up?
And then a swinging ram's head comes towards your party in the middle. So,
everybody.
Leolin, Ivana, Elceris, and Belarus all make a dexterity saving throw.
Come on, dice. Oh, wait, here's the saves. Here. Oh, my God. Okay.
Is that nice? All right, thank you. Okay.
So L got 3, and then I got 10. Horrible.
Okay. Nobody is safe from this ram's head battering ram that has dropped from the ceiling. You all are hit domino style, stacking one on top of each other as this ram's head first hits Belarus into Elceris, Elceris into Leolin, Leolin into Ivana, and then you all end up knocked back on the far wall. You all take 10 damage.
Everybody dead.
Yay. This is fun, right, guys?
So fun.
Speak for yourself. I'm covered in roof.
Fuck you.
Hey, you should be happy you're covered in roof. You didn't get hit.
Sorry, I should make this canon now. All right, Jericho, at this point, you are no longer covered in roof.
Thanks, Silver. I appreciate you, babe. With and the orange and blues.
I really wish you'd stop calling me that. Babe.
Yeah.
Hell.
Yeah. And then I give her the Brendan Fraser gif.
She smirks. We're just like Kevin Bacon. That's not canon. She didn't say that.
Invisible Man, Kevin Bacon.
Yeah. Oh, God, I hope not. Just... All right. So once you all finish taking that damage, oof, god damn, Silver goes over to where Jekogani and Penniman are, and she starts to investigate the draft. The draft area is what I should say.
Is the ram head still swinging?
No, the ram's head has stopped its momentum once it crashed all four of these people into the back.
Much like a battering ram trap in Skyrim, it only has one good swing in it.
Exactly. And then it just kind of hangs there, useless. So she is able to find a button that... wait, hang on for me 1 second. What did you roll? Sorry, I fucked this up. Again.
Again.
She is able to see on the other side is a much larger... She's able to see through a small crack where this draft is coming through. And she sees another room. She says, we have to... There's more to this wall. Help me find the switch. And that's all she says. And she frantically searches the wall.
We're all hurting. Do you think...
Oh, shit.
The dragon working again?
She taps on her dragon crest. And nothing happens.
Damn.
She is completely useless.
I'm not gonna lie. This doesn't happen all the time. This rarely happens to me. I can usually just kind of get these things up and at them when I have no issues with performing. You understand?
Now, my friend, she's trying her best.
Paladin, it seems like we need a rest or something because we need some... Some spells regain.
We are almost dead.
She searches the wall more, oblivious to your cries.
Oh wow! You know she can. I think that she can keep searching as we take a short break. She will not notice.
She can search for 8 hours.
You hear a rumbling in the distance of this temple.
Oh no.
The small pebbles from the roof of the temple shake down and kind of crumble where you guys are standing.
Oh no, not roof again!
Just traumatized. Poor
he's one natural enemy.
Roof.
I just came from the woods.
He'll never live in a house. He just always had to be under the stairs. Pause for a drink.
Yeah. Silver continues to look. She investigates the wall more.
I guess I will also investigate the wall.
Oh man. And she kicks.
Well, anyway.
She kicks the wall, and as she does, you hear a crink. As a stone has inserted into the wall further and has lodged itself there. The rumbling gets a lot louder. And then from the back of the wall, the ceiling, part of the ceiling opens up. And a huge tumbling boulder, Indiana Jones style, starts rolling towards your party. The boulder is at least 30 feet in width. Or, you know, 30 feet wide. So it is rolling towards your party. Currently is in the path of everybody but Jericho. What do you do?
Here, try again.
Will I dash out of the way?
Okay.
I should also like to dash out of the way.
I assume Elsaris is doing the same thing, right?
I will also dash out of the way.
Why don't you all go ahead and give me a dexterity saving throw?
Dash away, okay. Dash away, dash away, y'all.
You want a dexterity save or check?
Saving throw.
Okay, save. Okay. Oh.
The best part was when the roof almost came down and I almost lost it.
Ah, oh, man.
How did three of us roll an eight? How four of us roll an eight?
Four eights. Belarus got a 24, my man.
My man.
A dirty 24.
That's Silver. What did Silver get? Ah. Okay, well.
How did everyone
guess? Just because it's mine.
This dice roller's rigged.
Yeah, no shit, right? All right, so Ivana and Elsaris rolled an 8, Belarus rolled a 24. Is that right?
Correct.
Okay. Belarus and Ivana, you managed to evade out of the way. Meanwhile, everybody else in your party takes... I'm almost really scared to roll this.
...69 damage. No!
Oh.
Okay, two? Okay.
Okay, yeah, two damage. It was a light boulder.
Yeah, yeah.
It harmlessly clinks against the wall, and then, I mean, you all take two damage, but it's not that bad.
I'll take one damage with after uncanny dodge.
Nicely done. Okay. So you take only one damage. A light dusting off of your shoulder and you're back at it. So at this point, Silver turns to you guys and says, I don't think I should just go kicking stuff anymore.
That might be a good idea.
Anybody else have any suggestions?
Leolin, what's your HP?
I want to know that of but everybody's.
Right.
What everybody's.
Since Elsaris is right by. Well, Leolin probably has 44. The best.
Silver is pretty good.
Carl left. I forgot. Okay. So Silver is good. Leolin's probably good. Let's see. We got those.
Nice. All right. Okay. So you guys aren't doing too bad. Ish.
Jericho's 25. Okay, everyone's pretty good.
I had a roof.
Somewhat.
Yeah, you know what? No, roof was collapsed. Yeah. I just came from these roofs falling on me.
I just came from beneath the roof.
Elsaris is Elsaris is going to cure wounds himself.
Roll a charisma.
Hey, dirty 20.
Nice. You heal for all that you are allowed to heal for.
Oh, okay. Okay. I'll take it.
Yeah.
So.
Dirty 20.
That's his turn.
Okay. Let's see. Jericho, with your newfound rubble-free freedom, what are you doing?
And I got a question. Is the brick that somebody saw earlier, like that I heard about, do I know about that or do I not know about that? Do we have to keep investigating the wall?
What the hell are you talking about?
There was a exposed brick or something that looked weird. Like, can we go and like push that? Or
No, that's knowledge to the rest of the people. It was basically like it's a trap that was supposed to spring the battering ram, which instead was triggered by your carelessness or somebody else's carelessness.
Okay, so is the wall still up, right? We're trying to still get into that.
The wall is still up. There appears to be a draft coming from the room. Silver has yelled to the rest of the crew that there is another room behind the wall, or she believes another room behind the wall.
Okay.
She's frantically searching around at this point, thinking that there is still some sort of mechanism that unlocks something that should reveal the entrance to the next room.
Well, hell's bells, I'd like to get over there and help them look. I mean, shit, more of us going at it, giving it a go. Put on a large peppercorn over there.
I'll just throw you over there. Okay. But you keep changing your name.
It's the best.
It's pretty good.
I just came from the woods. All right.
You're doing an investigation check. Okay. Again. You get advantage on your investigation check, by the way.
Nice. It's weird that it's not reporting what I'm throwing, but 11 plus 2 is 13. Yes.
And you rolled twice, right?
No, just once.
With advantage, you roll twice and you take the higher number.
Oh, okay. Well, let me do that again then. Okay, well, the higher number wins. Okay, 15. All right.
You are able to tell that there is a mechanism, but you're unable to see where the mechanism is.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah.
I had roof on me.
Silver is too frightened to give another investigation check as her first one led to a boulder being thrashed at you. Jekogani, well, he is still surveying the area. So Pinnaman, what are you doing?
Well, I also kind of want to see what's going on in this next room, but I'm curious, did those lights go out in this corner? Can we see in this corner?
The only light is coming from the crack. The same place that the draft is coming through.
So I want to light a candle to illuminate the situation.
Nice. I
got a torch on me.
I don't think I'm not gonna make you roll anything to go ahead and light this torch or reveal the torch or whatever. Instead, you are able to see that the wall itself is on tracks. So something is keeping it up.
Oh.
So Silver's insight as to I think there's something behind this door is correct, as pretty much Jericho knows and everything else.
Well, I would definitely like to inspect these tracks then.
Okay, let's get another investigation check. I'll give you advantage. Because at this point, you've got a lot of hands searching this this wall.
19.
You are able to see a stone that seems out of place. You press it and...
Lick it.
Alexa, pause.
Lick it.
You are able to press it in. You taste a bittersweet salt. And, delicious. And then, hang on. The wall lowers itself down into a much bigger room.
Oh, hey guys, look!
You are confronted.
Cover your eyes, guys.
A pile of bone and gold as a black dragon sits atop of this pile of gold. God damn it. All right.
Oh, no.
Hang on for me 1 second. There was supposed to be something. Well, I can't. All right. Well, now you just get this. A black dragon sits a pile of gold.
Oh, no.
And let's go ahead and put all of you guys in here. And The dragon hisses at you as he spots you. You know what that means. Roll for initiative!
We're having dragon for dinner.
Oh, come on. Dang.
Wait, what do I need to roll?
Just a D20 for initiative.
Add your initiative modifier too.
Yeah, add your initiative. You know what I'm trying to do. Shut up.
Don't tell me what to do, Stan. Sorry, guys.
Sorry. Alexa, shuffle my playlist D&D action.
Shuffling your playlist. Amazon Music.
18's pretty good.
Okay, so. What do you guys have? Jericho. Come on. Pinnaman got 11.
Really wasn't expecting a dragon right now.
Elros got a 22. Leilani got a 5.
Finish him!
Jericho got a
5. Finish him!
Silver roll.
Since we tied, do I have to reroll?
Sure. I don't know. I don't think it'll. I don't think it matters on this. I think it'll do something where it'll either like put you guys in order, or like auto do something else or something like that. I've never actually encountered a same type of match number for this, so I don't know. And Ivana, you are 18. Okay. So, with everybody now lined up for initiative, Silver stops you all with her hand and says, "Wait a minute." And you look down, and her chest piece is glowing a brilliant blue. She taps it twice, and her blue-eyes white dragon friend emerges from her chest, tumbles out on the ground, kind of shakes his wings a little bit. You know how dogs do. And after that, she leans down to it, seeing that it's okay, and she goes, "I'm glad you're back with us, friend. We could use your help. Are you up for it?" And the little dragon kind of nods its head a little bit as it snuggles its head against her, and then leans back and it looks like it's about to throw up. And then it turns to the rest of Silver turns to the rest of the party and goes, "Huddle up, everyone." So she basically gathers you all forward or asks you to get closer to her. And as a result, you
we're gonna
all
go
do.
Out there. We're gonna give it 110%.
Yeah.
We're gonna get some balls and some baskets.
After you guys huddle up like this, the dragon lets loose with a spew of blue brilliant flame that circles the entirety of the party and heals you all for full health.
All right.
Do we feel rested in any way?
You feel energetic as a spearmint type of feeling courses through you. I don't know why spearmint is definitely the
rest? Like, do we feel short rested?
No, you feel long rested.
Oh, long rested. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Right.
Got me some spell slots.
The dragon lets loose with all of its fire, kind of circling it around, kind of going just left and right with its head as it's spewing out this blue flame. The flame dies down slightly, and the dragon coughs a little bit, some blue puffs of smoke, as it kind of wavers a little bit, stumbles, and then falls down exhausted. Silver picks up the dragon, whispers something to it, and then holds it deep to her chest to have it then transmorph back into the crest that appears on her armor. So now you are all healed, and she takes her sword by her side and says something that probably doesn't sound very badass, but, you know, says it anyway. I'll let you decide what that was.
No, you have to say it.
Okay.
That has to be canon.
Okay. Lisa, you got to take a long rest.
Yeah, Lisa, take a long rest. You've been healed.
You click on your profile character head, and then in that menu it says long rest.
Oh my god. I got it.
Nice.
I didn't know I actually
Yeah, she takes her sword, brings it down to her legs and says, let's fucking rage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I bust out a secret packet of cocaine I had in my pocket.
Okay. All right. That's canon. Fantasy cocaine. Yeah, there we go. That's how you make an interesting story.
So, I guess I should probably start.
Yes, you, Belarus, you're up first.
11-11.
Hey, there we are. All right. That's what I'm talking about. Now I feel juiced. Okay.
Let's probably get a better phrasing for that, right?
Yuck. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Like, yeah, not like, I mean, like energized, you know.
Either way. Doesn't matter.
Either way.
You were thinking of me coming, and that was that.
You know, I didn't want to say it out loud.
I made thick and his warm.
I'm sterile.
Wait, so Jay's mom is the worm?
Make thick in the worm.
I fucking love Big Mouth so much. It is so fucking disgusting. So, every single time I watch that show, it's like, oh my god, did they really say that?
Yeah, they just
we really do. But it also teaches wonderful lessons.
Yeah, it is so. I really loved when he was banging both the couch pillow and his pillow as well. That was really, really funny.
Right? It is okay to love both a couch pillow.
You're absolutely so good. Fuck yes, this show. What are you doing? I'm just letting little Dickie hang around. You know, it's no big deal. Fuck, that was so funny.
Such good shit.
This is Dragon, guys.
Oh, Dragon. Yeah. Dungeons and
Dragons. Dungeons and not Big Mouth. I forgot about that. Yeah, yeah.
I mean, the dragon has a big mouth, so it was.
So then there, so technically, it's there.
Okay.
There's still a dragon, and we can't hide from it, and now I'm worried.
So. I'm well.
I am going to try to cast
Alexa volume down.
Right, just the loudest.
Yeah, sorry about
dragon.
That.
Dragon! I am going to try to cast slow on the dragon. It has a range of 120, so I should be able to reach it without a problem.
All right. Let's, you already know.
So let's see, I need to do that and that. Okay, come on, give me a good roll. Good roll, okay, I don't know about that. Okay, I got a 14.
You failed to prone the dragon. It is now Ivana's turn. Ivana, what are you doing?
Okay, so let me see how far I am from this fucking... Where am I? Where'd my person go?
We left you in the other room.
No, it's, she's right...
Get that pointer out.
She's right there.
Okay, anyways, I'm really far away, so I don't think I can do anything. I gotta go closer.
Make sure you get behind one of those barriers.
All right, you guys.
All right, fine. Well, I can't grab my person because I don't see her.
That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. That's fine. That's fine.
I want to go. Oh, I see her. Hold up. I got her. I didn't know I can move this.
It's all good.
Can I go over here?
Yeah.
Okay. That's where I'm going.
That's your turn. All right, great. Thank you. And so now it's Jekogani's turn.
Oh, that's me. Hey.
I should have gotten a Mexican Coke for this particular party.
Yeah, what are you thinking?
Yeah, I wasn't. That was my problem.
We are going to...
Pickles, an onion.
Move behind cover right over here. And then cast Call Lightning.
You put your two meaty fingers between your mouth and you go like a big old dad whistle and you say Latin and you roll a charisma
wisdom.
Yeah, that's right. I don't know why I was thinking the other thing.
Wee weep, lightning.
Wee weep.
Did I get rid of the son of a bitch? I think I got rid of it. I got rid of my Discord. What did you roll?
12.
You whistle for the lightning, but the lightning doesn't strike. We now move on to Pinnaman, what are you doing?
I'm gonna move. Wait, where's my...
Yeah, I don't know. Either this room is really big or I just made your things really small or it's a new thing.
The room is huge.
I think it's a really big room.
Yeah, it looks big because when I measure, like, from me to the dragon's 100 feet.
Yeah, I really should have,
Is that wrong? I mean,
yeah, no. You see where the... All right, hang on for me 1 second. You see where this line is?
Yeah.
This is kind of where the wall is supposed to be.
Oh, we should be moved up.
Yeah, so you guys should all be kind of moved up way closer than this. Yeah.
I think my dude was over here.
Sorry about that.
Oh.
That was on me. I should have been a little bit better at this. First time using it, you know, trying to get this all taken care of as much as I can, and
we're way closer to Spyro than we imagined.
Right.
Also, I apologize for the look of the dragon's eyes. I don't know why it prints out like that, but
I love
it looks very Bebop and Rocksteady to me, and I just think
you should shut up because it looks amazing.
Yeah, it's wonderful. We all love it. Shut up.
Yeah, my wife did a pretty good job. So, all right, yeah. So you're doing your thing.
So can I then
the dragon is
pile of rubble I move to?
Yes.
I don't want to move closer to the dragon.
Yeah, no, I think you kind of have like a, like you're more kind of over here.
Over there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Unless that's not where you wanted to be.
Where do you want to be?
I'm like outside of immediate range of the dragon.
But yeah. Yeah.
Honestly, I'd probably move further away.
Okay. Well, that's your prerogative.
Back over here.
Like, send him to the squishy.
Yeah, I'm going back over there and instead.
Okay. Yeah, that's fine. all right.
In the wind instead of calling lightning, I'm going to do it over here.
Sounds good. We're just going to say that your turn counted. I should have had this all worked out, but whatever. Finneman, it's your turn.
Perfect. I would love to move behind the rubble to the left of me. And as I move, I would love to say to the paladin something along the lines of, please distract the dragon over there so I can attack it next time. And then I'm gonna shoot it with my crossbow.
Okay. Well, you're not moving that far, so I'm gonna. I'll definitely say, yeah, this is the thing. You know what? I'll let you move your character. I'm gonna stop trying to fucking move your shit. You fire off your crossbow while you're moving. Roll the dexterity. You manage to fire a shot off at this dragon, and it not only lands, it lands in its eye. The dragon now has partial vision, and so you have definitely hit. Let's roll that beautiful bean damage.
Five.
Nice. All right. One moment. Well, damage is damage.
Finish him.
And damage. Good, good, good. So now it's Jericho's turn.
Well, you know, this ain't really my scene, but I'm about to fuck this dragon up, so I'm going to go ahead and move my guy over here behind this rubble right there, and I'm gonna go ahead and fire off a hail of thorns at him.
Ooh.
Seems like the best.
Bringing the big guns. Okay, well,
right out the gate, because I mean, I got my long rest, so it's
I fucking love it. Let's go ahead and get that roll a dexterity, I think.
Son of a bitch. All right. where did it go? 3 plus 2. That'd be fun.
Okay. You manage to let loose your arrow, but it hits the pile of gold that the dragon is standing atop.
Expect it again.
Aeolin, it's your turn. Sorry about that.
I'm casting a level 3 fireball at the dragon.
Wee! Let's roll that wisdom, please. Yeah.
Charisma.
Charisma. Ooh, sorry.
6.
You did not manage to shoot this fireball. The fireball goes sort of over to where it is, but then it kind of tumbles away and disintegrates in midair before it actually hits the dragon. Let's see. So
the
now
worst
it's
round of rolling.
So now it's Silver's turn.
Dice are fucking bullshit.
This has been good.
We're all trying to do these big guns, and every single one is missing.
She first taps on her crest. And a blue light emerges, and then Winneman pops out of her chest into her hand. She whispers draconic words to it, and then she folds it into a ball and throws it as fast as she can to one side of the wall. When this happens, the dragon unfurls from its ball state and then tries to fly around the black dragon. and is distracting the black dragon. While this is happening, she casts.
What's that?
Oh God, does she actually? This is gonna do more damage. Okay, yeah, sure. She tries to use her greatsword. So she rolls a strength check. And does not manage to, she swings her sword at nothing. So she doesn't get her bonus attack either. The dragon's still distracted, because Winneman is, weakly flying around it. But it only looks like it has another, like, two or three passes around before it, is going to be too tuckered out. So now we move on to the dragon, who is still distracted. We move on to El Saris.
El Saris is going to move. Towards Jericho. And also be behind this rubble over here. I'm going to move 20 feet, and then cast the frost, Ray of Frost.
Okay, move your character and then do your thing, and then evoke your charisma magic.
Ray
your charis magic.
Charis magic, nice.
Yeah, I tried.
Okay. So first see if it pops off.
Yeah.
So if I have to see if it pops off, then I also have like a hit plus 7.
Uh-huh.
Like, do you want me to see if it pops off and then also do my magic hit? Does that make sense?
Well, I want you to roll to see if you're actually to see if you successfully cast the spell.
So see if I cast it and see if I hit. Gotcha.
Yeah.
All right. So let's see. All right, we got a dirty 22 for popping it off.
Nice, so that hits.
Outstanding.
Finally.
Yeah.
And then, shoot, I don't know what they mean for that one. It must be a D20 as well.
All of that one.
7.
Because I don't know.
Or can I skip that if it pops off? You know what I mean?
What the hell are you talking about?
Like, I'm looking at Ray of Frost on his sheet, and it says hit slash DC plus 7.
Slash DC plus 7.
Do you see that on the sheet? So Ray of Frost, it's a cantrip, channel magic, 60 feet, hit slash DC plus 7. So on my magic attack, like, I get plus 7 for this one.
Yeah.
So I'll just do that, okay.
Yeah.
All
right. Makes sense to me.
So it's a 15.
Ooh. That hits.
I like it. All right. And then, 2d8. I like it. Let's do that. 3. All right, total of 9 damage.
Ooh, all right. Nice little 9 damage action.
Outstanding.
Okay, great.
It's
so,
reduced by 10 feet until the start of its next turn.
Okay.
So it gets a little reduction. It's a little cold. It's got cold feet.
Sure. That makes sense. Let's see. It's now Belarus's turn. So, Belarus, what are you doing?
Yes. I am going to attempt to cast slow on the dragon once again, and if I'm able to do so, I shall be happy.
Okay.
The fuck was that? All right, so
outstanding.
Finish him.
So you want a charisma check. Let's throw that down. Come on, baby. Hurting my feelings.
Oof. It does not hit its intended target. Instead, it just kind of flitters away as you're casting it. So now we turn to Ivana. Ivana, what are you doing?
Okay, so I want to, hold up, let me minimize this. I'd like to do Hail of Thorns, second level.
Sick. Let's get the dexterity to see if you, yeah.
And that's going to be... Eight.
You let loose with that arrow. It flies right past the dragon into the wall, and the arrow breaks. So now it's Jack O'Gani's turn. Jack O'Gani, what are we doing?
I am going to enter starry form.
Ooh, okay.
In the archer constellation.
Nice.
And then attempt to call lightning once again.
That's fucking beautiful. All right, so I'm going to give you advantage because you're in your Sagittarius starry form. I feel like that gives you more...
Sex.
We're within the cosmos. I'm going to say that you... What little light shines through to this temple radiates onto you. Different stars glow on your body. You are then transformed into this silhouetted, galaxy-colored Adonis with a powerful galaxy-colored bow. And yeah, so go ahead and shoot your shot.
All right, 21.
Holy fucking shit! Yeah, that hits.
Outstanding.
Yeah, fuck yeah. Let's, I'll give you plus five to whatever damage you're about to deal.
Cool. So now, just so we're clear, I do have a storm cloud in the room, and every turn, once per turn, I can call lightning down from it.
Nice. Dragon. Nice.
So I'm going to roll for my call lightning damage first, and then I will roll for my archer damage after that.
Okay. I am, yeah. So, yeah, give me that lightning damage first, then we'll see what's going on. That's a fucking cool spell, man. That's a really cool fucking spell.
You said plus five?
Yeah.
So the lightning damage is 33.
Fucking shit. Yeah! Fuck yeah!
I shit, I fart, I cummed.
Wow. Okay.
And then eight from the archer.
Still pretty. damage. Man, hit for a lot. Awesome. We now move on to Penniman. What's Penniman doing?
Well, I'm just in awe at.
I think they're, yeah, all of your team is really just.
So I like have to take a second and like catch my breath, but then also realize, ah, crap, this thing's distracted, so I want to shoot it with my crossbow.
Nice. Let's, it's a sneak attack, I'd say. You know, it's a distracted, you're behind rubble.
Shocked, and there's also like a little smaller dragon flying around. And,
yeah,
like,
it's definitely distracted. It cannot see you.
Paladin came through for me. So like I had to like thank the spores and the stars for that. So
oh yeah. Oh god. I still like to think that there's like a 6'7" Jack O'Gani that's just like all galaxy colored out. Just kind of standing just over there in the distance, still glowing. It's pretty rad. Just like, man, okay.
Kind of like the forest spirit in Princess Mononoke.
Yeah. What? Yeah.
25.
Yeah, I hit.
Outstanding.
Let's roll that beautiful bean damage.
plus 3. Roll your 3d6 sneak attack. Twenty-five.
Holy shit, really? Man, you guys are doing this a lot quicker than I thought you were going to. All right.
It was all due to my mouth being so agape.
Yeah. No, I've been there. I was on the Pokemon poke crawl. I get it.
No shit.
Oh, I miss it.
A lot of fun. Yeah, me too.
Oh,
Soon.
Probably not this year.
2022. We're back on.
This isn't goodbye. This is I'll see you later. Jericho, it's your turn. What are we doing? You scarfed down a bowl of Cheerios.
Yes. No, I'm going to go for the other.
The honey nut variety.
I feel like right now, my chances are as good as any. I don't think he can see me still, so I might as well try to loosen arrow and hit him in the other eye, make him completely blind. So
I really like where you're going with this. Let's roll that dexterity.
All right, motherfucker. I don't know what it is. It's not telling me what it is anymore.
Six. Okay. You let loose an arrow. It skims past the dragon, almost hits Winneman, and it sails into the ceiling and breaks apart. Silver yells, careful, you idiot!
I yell back, it's not my fault. There's Saris is jacking off next to me again.
Canon. That's not canon. I don't want to let anybody speak for somebody else. Hang on. What's Alceris doing while this blatant lie has been said?
Can we get Ray on speakerphone to confirm?
Ray, Justin just said that your character is jacking off. We're battling a dragon.
Leolin, it's your turn.
I'm trying for Fireball again.
Okay, roll a wisdom.
Charisma?
Charisma.
12.
Shut up. It poofs into ash as it gets close to the dragon but doesn't hit. Silver's up next. She is going to cast... Holy shit, she can do that? All right, she's going to cast a level 5 hold person on the dragon. Yeah. Whoa. Hang on. Let's see if she can actually do this. No! Instead, she just gets constipated. So now it's the dragon's turn. The dragon snaps at Winneman. Mrs. Winneman by a hair. Winneman flies back to Silver's chest, pops onto her armor, and then transmorphs. The dragon then uses bite to go after Belleros. No, sorry. Within his line of sight. Alceris. Because it does have blindsight. Oh, and it hits. Oh, boy. Ooh, boy.
He was jacking off, too.
So Alceris. Alceris is going to take this damage here real quick. Hang on for me 1 second. Oh, God, I hope not. Yeah, you're telling
me. But I'm behind some rubble.
It's got blindsight. So it knows it knows that you're there. That is 11. Oh, plus 6. That's 17 damage that Alceris takes. And then for its second attack, it goes after Jericho with its claws. and misses Jericho by a hair, and then sees Ivana and uses its other claw to swipe at her. And misses with its other claw. So that's good. So now it is El Saris' turn. What is El Saris doing?
I am going to...
I'm tracking it. All right, great.
Hold my wound. As...
okay. Ouchies.
Ouchie bagouchies.
I'm glad you add the bagosh in there. That was pretty fun.
Okay, how pissed am I? I'm a little perturbed here, guys. Using the spell side 11 higher, you can one additional. Fuck that. Okay.
Because I see that I have. I see that there's a drop of blood coming from me. I use my spell magic and my rage to cast Bane onto the dragon.
Oh.
Up to three creatures of your choice that you can see within range must make charisma saving throws. Whenever a target that fails this saving throw makes an attack, roll, or a saving throw before the spell ends, the target must roll a d4 and subtract the number rolled from the attack, roll, or saving throw.
Okay.
Gotta be your boy.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Killing me here. 13?
Oh.
Please?
And what is the dragon's wisdom? The dragon is not subdued by your magic. And just as you think it is about to be transfixed, wand of vision style, with your chaotic magic, it shakes its head and frees itself of your ensnarement. So now it is Belarosa's turn.
Okay.
I am once again going to try to cast slow.
Wait, before I go, here's a DM question.
So yeah, sure.
My bardic inspirations are a bonus action.
Yeah.
Should I assume that I basically will not be able to use my bardic inspirations unless I successfully do an action?
You are correct.
Okay. Could I ever forego an action and do a bardic inspiration?
I'll allow that.
Okay. I will keep that in my back pocket, for I will try.
Sure.
To... Nope, you know what?
You just try to psych up people instead of actually taking a turn. Yeah.
Yeah, that's... no, I'm going to try. I'm going to try to cast slow again.
I'm okay. Going to cast slow once again.
Come on. Okay, maybe. Okay, 17. I feel good about that.
That hits. Definitely. Hell yeah. So then...
Let me read it off to you, I suppose.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. Slow.
Three creatures of room.
This one's a concentration for up to a minute. Are you reading it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Target must roll a d4 and subtract the number rolled from the attack roll of saving throw. Basically, yeah. All right, so then the next time this dragon lets loose with anything, it's got to go ahead and take a d4 and subtract the number rolled from that roll that it was just given. So if it rolls to... this is just how I'm interpreting this. I think that means that if it goes to an attacks with its bite...
and rolls, let's say, like a 18 or something like that, then I would take a further d4 and subtract that number from the number that was just rolled.
Is that for slow or for Bane?
For Bane.
No, we're doing slow, bud.
Oh, damn it. All right, no worries.
Sorry. I got you.
Yeah. All right,
so you alter time around up to 6 creatures of your choice up to 40 feet in a 40-foot cube within range. Each target must succeed a wisdom saving throw or be affected by this spell for the duration of 1 minute.
Okay.
An affected target's speed is halved. It takes a -2 penalty to AC and dexterity saving throws. It can't use reactions. On its turn, it can use either an action or bonus action, not both, regardless of the creature's ability or magic item. It can't make more than one melee or ranged attack during its turn. If the creature attempts to cast a spell with a casting time of one action, roll a d20. Does it do any magic?
No, not that I'm saying. I think it's just you physically slow the creature, or time around the creature slows down, and it appears as if it is. To it then. Yeah, it appears as if it's a lot slower.
Spell makes another wisdom saving throw at the end of each of its turns. On a successful save, the effect ends.
Yeah.
So, okay, well then, fantastic. It has that debuff, and then I'm going to...
Not to mention that it still has a rain cloud above its head that can cast... That is a potential lightning storm waiting to happen.
Which is awesome.
Yeah, so this is a slowed down dragon caught up in a lightning storm. No longer distracted, but its speed is halved. So
I'm going to give a mote of inspiration to Elceris.
Now you did use slow on the dragon.
Right, so I get my bardic.
That's right, as a bonus action. Yeah, all right. So, and then who are you giving it to?
Elceris, I should give you a bonus, a mote of inspiration. Inspiration.
And then Elceris is like, thank you.
Thanks, bud. And that's pretty good. Don't want to get sued. Never mind, he doesn't say that. I'm not Wolverine, is what he says. Ivana, it's your turn.
Okay, so I'm just gonna do Hail of Thorns again.
Awesome. Give me a dexterity.
Okay. Okay. 16.
That hits.
Outstanding.
You let loose with that arrow. It flies in the air, and you shout sting, and the arrow splits itself into 15 different arrows that rain down on this creature. You hit it for 12.
Yep.
Nice. Very cool. Come on. Okay, good. It is now Jekogani's turn. What are you doing, Jekogani?
I'm going to call down another lightning bolt on this bee.
Fuck yeah. I'm just going to say you just rolled that beautiful bean damage. It's already up there. It's no reason that you would need to cast more magic in order to bring this down.
Boys. Uh, 24 from the lightning, and then I'm also going to shoot an archer arrow.
Fatality.
Okay.
Wow.
For another 8.
Hell yeah. It has significantly hurt the dragon. The dragon is now bloodied after the lightning hit. So you've reduced its health by at least half. It's still slow. It still has a rain cloud above its head. Yeah, it's bloodied, and you can see that it is now bloodied. Quickly, Pin, it's your turn. What are you doing?
Just clapping for that, but then also yeah. Just like, as I clap, just like sighing.
Sorry, what did you say?
Another like, I'm like clapping and then just like peering with my...
Yeah, yeah, all right, I could definitely... that's so good. All right, yeah, no, I could definitely see that happening. Let's, I'm gonna say, you're so inspired by the lightning storm that you just saw. I'm gonna give you advantage on your roll. Why don't you roll that dexterity?
Outstanding.
That hits. Why don't you give me that beautiful bean damage?
Seven.
14. Oh my god. Alright, yeah, sure. Kick ass.
Fatality.
Man, this thing is super bloody. Jericho, it's your turn.
I'm gonna go ahead and loose another arrow and try to fire it off.
Dexterity, please. 8 hits.
Outstanding.
Let's give me let's roll that beautiful bean damage. 9. It's that's a pretty good damage. Leolin, it's your turn.
Going for the fireball again.
Let's roll that charisma, please.
Although this one's weird. It says, Dex 15.
Uh-huh.
So instead for that one, it seems like I should be rolling dexterity instead for this specific spell, right?
That makes sense. No, no? That's not what that means? No. Explain, please.
It's a save. It means that on a successful cast of the spell, the uh-huh. enemy has to roll a dexterity saving throw.
And since the dragon is slowed, it can't give it. Okay.
Right, and it's gonna suck shit in.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. So now you know.
So, because it says attack / save dex 15.
Yeah, that's right, the
so
saving.
So they have to roll a saving throw.
Yeah. I'd listen to these guys.
So why is it in the same column on my character sheet as the things I click to attack?
That's so the other person knows. Like, you can tell them, oh, you have to make a dexterity saving throw if I...
No, you know, I don't think so.
Let's see. Let's see what's
going on. Oh, my God.
Under your spells, right?
Fucking Windows.
Where it says hit / DC or what?
No. Okay.
I'm looking at the wrong.
Okay. See on Scorching Ray, it says +7 and there's a button to click.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's what I click for attack, right?
Yep.
Okay. Right above it, it's fireball in the same column. It says dex 15.
Yep.
So what does that mean?
That's still the saving throw that the enemy makes when you cast it successfully.
So why does Scorching Ray have a thing I can click to attack, but Fireball doesn't?
That's maybe because really of the different kind of magic that you use, like one's like a cantrip and the other one's like a...
No, they're not cantrips. They're both level spells.
Well, then so I have
some, some spells you just do, and some spells you have to make a spelling attack. You have to make a spell attack. Some spells they just go, and some spells you have to make a spell attack. So it's like equal to your proficiency plus your whatever you use for spells.
Hmm.
So I would
argue, based on what I've read so far, that anything that has something like that, you cast the spell successfully anytime you cast it, and then it's just whether the creature can save or not.
Right.
I think. I don't know.
That's what the videos I was watching says.
The way I'm looking at it, it just seems like it's regular magic to me, but I don't know.
Okay. All right. Well, I'm just going to roll charisma then.
Okay. Yeah. Roll a charisma. See what happens.
And I got a 6, so... Let's move on.
All right.
It was a good talk. Good talk.
And then lastly, Silver will cast Hunter's Mark on the dragon and then let loose with an arrow. And she hits! Holy shit! All right, give me a moment. I didn't expect this.
I didn't know she could shoot arrows.
I didn't think she could hit anything.
Good job.
Yeah. So, characters... There. Yeah. Okay. So she cast that. Yes. It is 1d6 plus main. So, all right. So she does 2 damage. Ah, great. Okay. God damn it. Even she.
A good try.
Yeah, I guess. 2 damage. So now it is the dragon's turn, but the dragon is slow, as well as blind in one eye, and snapping at the cloud above it. So now it's Elceris' turn.
Elceris. Okay. Elceris is going to cast Cure Wounds on himself.
Okay. Roll that magic.
Ouch, bro. I rolled a modified 8.
Do not manage to cast your cure wounds. You try to let it go, and instead you squeeze out a fart. That is that. And with that, Alexa, pause. I think we're going to pause it for tonight. You are in the middle of a battle with a dragon. You've definitely got it down to half health, if not more. And that is where you're at in this particular game. Again, the entire reason why you were here was to get a dragon. So.
Oh, like alive or dead? That's an important.
Yeah. So that's pretty much that, and we can stop the share. Good. All right. let's see. That's
pickles and onions.
Tasha swirls her staff in her homebrewed realm of wonder and fantasy, where the ruin or riches that befall you rely on polyhedral deities. A heart-shaped skull comprised of the fumes of the homebrew rise as her astral forms plunge out of her realm, full of demons and angels, elves and magic. Dungeons.
Everybody. Yeah.
Thank you guys for.
I managed to do nothing except smash a giant head into the entire party.
It was,
you know, that Carl, was, that was cool. I looked at cool. cracks on the floor.
I was covered in roof.
We can't hear you anymore, Josh.
Yeah, I can't hear you, Shua.
No, hey, everybody, I'm Josh.
Stupid. You're muted.
Like, he shouldn't be. I don't know why he's muted. That's weird.
I think his soundboard is janky. Yep.
His USB microphone died.
Oh, no.
They're trying to unplugging it and plugging it back in.
Call it a night then, and on behalf of our overlord, you all gain 4,000 experience and 8,000 gold.
Okay, so are we good now?
Can
we? Yes,
it's working. Yeah, yeah, yeah. As soon as 4,000 XP was canon, all of a sudden that mic popped right in.
Yeah, of course.
I wish that this thing would just work for me.
Anyway, no, this was a super fun time, you guys. Thank you so much for plunging into Dungeons & Dragons with me. What's everybody's schedule looking like for next weekend? Is everybody here going to be able to play, or are you guys busy?
Well, we're still in full-on pandemic, so I'm free.
We're good, but on the 20th of March, we're going to be out of town for family stuff.
Okay.
Yay!
Well, that's at least something.
Yay, family stuff, Seth.
There was a...
I'm sorry.
Yeah, oh, it's a funeral?
Kind of, yeah.
Oh, that stinks. Yeah, that's, yeah.
Are there also two weddings?
Always.
Because that's like a movie. Or a book, probably, first.
My father is an astounding man! That's not what he says. That's not what he says at all. That's not the line. Sorry.
What's your schedule?
Yeah, I'll see you guys later.
That's four. You gonna just four?
I'm gonna just think about that joke that I just made and worry about it.
3 hours and 59 minutes.
That's correct.
There's a four.
Oh my god.
Holy cow. All right, bye. Good night. Good job.
Bye.
GG's.
GG's, guys.
GG's.